Now we're actually going to use these templates. First thing we're going to learn is variable substitution. The syntax for substituting a variable in Jinja is just double curly braces. And then you include your variable name, and then you close your curly braces. Pretty simple, right? Basically, these curly braces, it just means print. It's as if you typed a print statement in the middle of your HTML code. So let's see what that looks like in practice. Okay, I'm going to go into my shopping list HTML file and I'm just going to add a string right to the bottom of the file. Okay, so I just said hello, and then I added in curly curly name. Now, where is name defined? It is not defined anywhere yet. Let's see what happens when I reload this page with just this. Here I am in the browser. Let's reload this page. And it says hello, and there's nothing there. Actually, we can get rid of this ig. That's a little leftover. So Jinja, if the variable is not defined, just quietly doesn't include it. Now let's go ahead and include name. Let's just kind of hack this in real quick. Name equals Steve. OK, so remember before I was talking about this star star syntax, name equals Steve basically gets passed in as star star kw, which gets passed along here, which gets received by render string as star star params, just different variable names to be deliberately confusing for some reason, and which gets passed into the render function from Jinja, which expects keyword parameters. So it's going to define name equals Steve. And if we go to our browser and reload this, we see it says, hello, Steve. Let's see if we can make this a little bit fancier. What if instead of name equals Steve all the time, we said name equals self.request.getName? So we can put name as a parameter. Let's see if that works. OK, if I reload this page, I get nothing because there is no parameter. But if I add name equals Udacity, we can see that Udacity appears in our template. OK, so right now we basically have this very elaborate way of doing string substitution via these files. But we can already see we're somewhat on the right direction of having cleaner code. And time for a quick quiz. OK, so what I want you to do is use variable substitution, the syntax I just showed you, to make this string. The quick brown and then the variable animal 1 jumped over the lazy and then the variable animal 2. Go ahead and type this complete string with the correct variable substitutions for these variables in the box here.